Hi, so in this section we are talking about layout and design, and this is mostly for the self-published author, but the traditional author can also focus on this as well, because when you get your manuscript back, you know, or proofed, you definitely have input on how you want it to look. You know, if you want a hardcover, if you want a soft cover, if you want book jackets, you know, how it's going to be laid out inside. Do you want pictures? Do you want bolded text? What kind of font would you like to use? What point font would you like to use? And if all of this sounds like foreign language to you, don't worry, we're going to cover it. So the reason I know a little bit about book formatting is because I do have a graphic design background, which definitely helped when I self-published my first book. And our first topic we're going to cover is book formatting and how you lay out a book. And if you refer to your course handbook, I have an example there that you can go over as I'm going through what to do. So book formatting, it's so many different aspects to it. It's so many different sizes. It's a lot. So you definitely need to do your research. You need to know how big you want your book to be. What sizes? Do you want black and white? Do you want color? How do you want your cover to look? Have you even thought about a cover? Those type of things are very, very important. And like I say, it really depends on what message you're trying to convey. I have formatted books, and I formatted lots of books in the fiction world for publishers. And those book standard size that I have used are 8.5 by 5.5. And, you know, roughly this size. And it's all about layout. So when I lay out a book, generally you want your book to be probably between 200, 300 pages, maybe 400 pages. You want to give your reader a very good story to read, and you want to have a nice length. So, you know, they'll keep coming back. They know you're a good storyteller, and they know that it's worth their money. That they're the consumer. Consumers are big on not wasting money. So this is very important. And this also helps how you format your book, because sometimes book can be too long and it can be overwhelming for a reader. Some readers don't want to feel like they're reading a 1,000-page book because, you know, it's overwhelming. They're like, can I really get through this? You know, between the job, the kids, the family, am I going to have time to really read this? So when book formatting comes in, you actually have the leeway to make this book smaller, you know, just playing with fonts and playing with line spacing. And if you look at your examples in your course book, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. And if you have access to InDesign or Word, which all of you should have access to if you're typing out a manuscript, because you can also format books in Word, there I gave you a easy template to follow just to show you how to format your book and get you on the ground running. So do the exercise that I have, and then please go to the Q&A section and definitely show me what you've come up with. I'm very interested to see.